Hey everybody, Sean Hatzel here with Get Lean After 40, and today's dry sauna rapid fat loss video, I want to talk intermittent fasting for people over 40. Because there's several different methods that are buzzing around the internet like right now, like a mosquito, and I have a favorite method that I want to share with you at the end of this video. So I want to talk about three different intermittent fasting protocols that people over 40 can use, along with my favorite. I also want to talk about a brand new study from Harvard. And before we dive into these intermittent fasting methods, it's important that you understand the benefits of fasting and having a feeding and a fasting window. So fasting each day for a set period of time that I'll discuss in just a second, and then feeding for a set period of time, at least 4 or 5 days per week, can regulate your metabolism, can optimize your hormones, and it can actually help increase lifespan. Now, during the fasted window, you also kick up your body's sympathetic nervous system. This releases fat-burning hormones like adrenaline and growth hormone. At the same time, your ghrelin levels become regulated. Ghrelin helps you control hunger and craving. So during this fasted window, you will not get hungry. Just make sure that you drink plenty of water. Now, there's brand new research on the mitochondria. Now, if you didn't know what the mitochondria was, it is the powerhouse of the fat cell. And I just had this pulled up right here. And that is a brand new study from Harvard. And it showed, this research shows that fasting can increase lifespan. It can slow aging. It can improve your health and your fat loss by altering the activity of the mitochondria. The mitochondria is the powerhouse of the fat cell. So the more efficient we are at optimizing our mitochondria, the more efficiently our body's gonna use stored fat cells as a fuel source. So what are the three best methods? Method number one is the 24-hour fast. This is longer, not my favorite. It works best after a cheat day when you've overeaten some carbs and other foods, where you fast for simply 24 hours. So you might have your last meal like say 7 or 8 p.m. at night, and then you would not break your fast again till the next day. Now, I only recommend that you do this once or twice a week if you're gonna go this long in fasting. And the research is pretty remarkable behind this. When you start getting into these longer fasts, you really experience a lot of what's called autophagy. This is where your internal cells start cleansing themselves. And then a study showed that after 48 hours of fasting, which I don't recommend, but it goes to prove a point, metabolic rate went up 12%, growth hormone increased 1,200%. So you're actually increasing your metabolism and your fat-burning hormones during this fasted window. Most people would think our metabolism would slow down or we'd burn muscle, and it's just not the case. You're using stored fat for energy, and it really increases the brain health to increase your mental clarity and your focus. So 24 hours once or twice a week. Now, the second best method is to use a 12-hour fast. Now, this would be more like for beginners that have never fasted before. And you could do this Monday through Friday where you have your last meal at 6 to 9 p.m. And then you break your fast 12 hours later at 6 to 9 a.m. Now, after you do this for a week or two, you want to extend this window out even further and use my favorite method. And you can learn all about the brand new scientific research studies behind this method. I call it the Over 40 Hormone Reset Solution. It's a one-day diet protocol you can learn about by clicking or tapping the link around this video. But I personally use this to fast 16 to 18 hours, about 4 days per week, sometimes five. And so in other words, I would have my last meal. I typically have my last meal at 9 p.m. It's usually a protein shake, and I'll go to bed an hour and a half later. So after that protein shake, an hour and a half later, my insulin's more stabilized. So when I go to sleep, I'll have more growth hormone pulses throughout the night because that insulin is stabilized. But I'm still feeding my muscle and boosting my metabolism with a hefty dose of protein before bed. Now, the next day, I will not eat again until 1 to 3 p.m., so the 16 to 18 hour mark. So I literally will not eat, and I will just fast and drink water, and I'll have black coffee, and I won't add any sweeteners or creamers to that. And then I also like to do some apple cider vinegar, some fresh squeezed lemon juice, and some sea salt. And I just choke it down. I'm not a fan of the taste of that at all. The lemon helps, but I choke it down because it wakes up the adrenal glands and it promotes healthy digestive health during the fast, and it can help prevent hunger cravings that you would normally get during a fasted window. But after a week or two of doing this, ghrelin's going to regulate and it will not matter. So if you want to learn how to use this method, that's my light again, that's specifically designed for the hormonal condition of people over 40, just click or tap the link around this video, go over to my website. Hopefully you got something out of this. If you did, do me a favor, share it, like it. And knowledge is only power when it's applied. So please go apply this stuff and report back and let me know how you're doing. Thanks for watching, and God bless.